the iPhone XS Maxes. We're gonna see if they survive being shot by the world's most powerful leaf blower.
Okay, what are we doing today?
I got an arm.
Today, we're gonna build the world's largest and most expensive leaf blower
in the world.
We've got an 8-inch concrete cardboard tube. We've got some carbon fiber that we can wrap it with. And of course, we have a $5,000 custom EDF from Schubler that we originally got for the Flying Like Iron Man project. So let's slap it together, make some handles, add some batteries.
Yep.
And put on an Iron Man costume and then blow all the neighbors' leaves.
Mugs.
Where should I go?
Coffee.
Where's my coffee?
What?
We attach the tube on here. Attach a handle on here. Okay. And then we're gonna wrap brand new lithium ion batteries from Energys around the outside. You grab the batteries and figure out just how many of these we need.
One of these will be able to provide the current, but we're gonna need 14 cells of these to provide the voltage.
Oh, we're so close. There. Oh. Oh, yeah. It's actually. It's carbon fiber, Bogdan. Whoosh!
Look at my 8-inch tube.
This video is sponsored by Casetify. Casetify makes the slimmest, most protective phone cases with a 2x military-grade protection. And we're going to test to see just how protective they really are.
Going to do a drop test, 2 meters. There we go.
Yeah!
Woo. Oh yeah!
No problem.
Sweet.
You can find the case that's perfect for you by choosing from cute, trendy, or classic pre-made designs, or custom design your very own. They made us some awesome Hacksmith cases for these tests. Click the link in the description below and use the coupon code THEHACKSMITH to save 20% off your first iPhone case. Now, for the fun part. Casetify asked us to test their case on a new iPhone XS with one of our projects. So, that's exactly what we're going to do. Stick around to the end of the video to see us launch these iPhones out of the finished leaf blower.
Yay! Oh, that was so frightening.
Okay. I figured I'd just carbon fiber.
So, do any of us know how to do this?
Nope. Squish it!
Squish it, squish it. You getting your doctorate? Whatever James tells you to do.
It worked.
Oh, it's square.
Press. Yeah, okay.
Need a more. Drop that.
Whoa.
What?
That turned out pretty good.
Oh.
Hello.
This is genuinely like frightening to watch.
Oh.
You have
I mean,
to
this thing's gonna be a leaf blower forever, right? Our $5,000 company leaf blower.
The thing is, this can be used to clean up all of our smashy stuff, because this will easily blow off like glass and whatnot.
Fits first of all.
It doesn't.
Of course. Gotta make sure the batteries fit, right?
That's a good point.
Blue on the outside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And 14. Perfect.
Jeez, that's gonna break really fast.
Yeah. Even cut another ring, and even just super glue it on.
Follow us on Instagram. Why don't you just plasma cut a ring of metal and another ring of metal?
Because we would need something that's conductive, and iron is terrible at that.
That's why we use steel.
Riley, what do you think steel is made out of?
There's some iron in it.
Okay.
Yeah, why don't we plasma cut a cool f***ing like... Zip, 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 zip. Oh, wait, no. Never mind.
Why?
I made a dum-dum.
Why?
So connect all the batteries in series and parallel at the same time. Ultimate infinite
power. It's Jim Bagnon.
Figuring out how to fix this whole thing.
Does it fit?
Yes.
Okay. Explain to the viewers why this is so dangerous.
Well, see, this is the positive end of the battery, and this is the negative end. And this battery, each one of these can output 800 amps. So just dropping a washer right in between there would cause a big spark, and it probably welds itself.
So don't drop a washer then.
All right, so that's actually a really good question. What would happen if we shorted the terminals of this battery with a washer? Let's see. Just bring your face a little closer.
This is such a bad idea. I love it.
These batteries are actually incredibly safe. Each cell is actually fused at the end. So hypothetically, it's going to draw as much current as it can, and we'll record that right there. And then hopefully they'll just like melt at the ends of the battery or something.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Just want to make sure I can, you know.
Oh, that's getting hot.
Okay, so we got some smoke from the plastic. See, all the fuse is melted, and now the current cannot pass through. All right, so it survived being shorted. What would happen if we hit it?
Okay, boss. Corny a potato. No. It's happening.
In the garage.
Okay, so I calculated the CFM of what the Schubler would be outputting at its peak, which is probably what we'll be running it at. About 4,500 CFM, which is cubic feet per minute. So then I looked up what the most powerful lawn blowers, leaf blowers, the backpack ones are, and they're about 900 CFM. So we're in a different range of
almost five
of
times
moving about. Leaves.
Actually, exactly 500 times as well.
Yeah, just about. Okay, Bogdan, so since this thing is so dangerous, how are we going to make it safer?
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take a photo of this, make a pattern of that shape there, and then go all the way around, and laser cutting would be a terrible idea. Laser cut a plate to go on top of that to basically make a spacer, and then an acrylic plate to go over all of it, so that nothing can come in contact with these two, and they'll still be transparent.
Watch your ring. Watch that ring. Watch it. Hey, engineering ring's gonna kill you. Where is the fire extinguisher? Yeah, it works. There you go, Biden. Imagine dropping a wrench between any two of those. That's why I brought the fire extinguisher up.
Yeah, literally if you...
Is there any CO2 in this?
No?
I know I said a bigger arc reactor wouldn't make a difference, but it's a bigger arc reactor.
It's way too big, brah. Brah.
Brah.
Brah, your triangles. Too big, brah.
Alright, let's blaze it. I mean, plasma cut.
This is what?
24 kilograms thrust?
Yeah. So that's also gonna be like 50 pounds pulling back. Like seriously, like if I tried holding this and turning it on, I can't resist that. Oh my god. Why do we make everything so heavy? Okay, yeah, we need the strap in between because literally this will just push itself away from the battery.
We are ready to do a quick little test.
We should really test this thing first and figure out to make sure it's in the right mode and everything.
Waiting for you about
2,000 years later.
Think it's gonna be a spark?
Pardon?
Gonna spark?
Can it spark?
Is it going to spark?
I have no clue, probably, yes. Most definitely, actually, yes.
Here we go.
Do.
Is it blowing the right way?
Or no?
Yep.
Good. It's minimum power.
So what happens if you unplug that?
Want to try it? Okay, unplug it.
Yep.
Three, two. Yes. Okay, let's plug this back in.
And it stays the same power. Sweet. That means this button will work perfectly.
Yeah.
We actually have a more detailed electronics diagram, which you can check out using the link in the description below to visit our project on maker.io.
It works!
Yay!
This will blow you away. You might want to get a shoulder strap.
Is that gonna hold?
Yeah.
That's gonna hold 24 kilograms of thrust plus the weight of this thing.
Yes.
Looser. You can make this one looser.
There we go.
Nothing that could possibly go wrong.
Like not even 10% power.
Sorry.
You go outside?
I guess so.
Bye-bye, leaves.
I'm still on like 10% power. All right, so we're outside now with the iPhone XS Maxes, and we're gonna see if they survive being shot by the world's most powerful leaf blower. So I'm gonna start recording a video on the phone. Hopefully it survives. And it's still recording! There's a bit of dirt on it. Yeah. Alright, so let's try that again. We're gonna hit record. Jairus is going to catch and save the iPhone, but if he doesn't, it's okay.
Alright, here we go.
Woo!
Woo!
We're gonna launch two iPhones at once. So the screen did get a bit scratched.
A case test to protect the screen.
That was awesome. It's the view from inside the leaf blower.
Wow, that is so cool.
Smack, roof,
throw your
concrete. And then, 3, 2, 1.
It's good, it's good. It's good.
Well, the iPhone survived being shot 30 plus feet in the air. We probably should have put a screen protector on them though. Check out Casetify using my link in the description below and save 20% using our coupon code. Anyway, this has got to be one of my favorite quick builds ever. We actually made the majority of it in one Saturday afternoon, though troubleshooting and filming took weeks. The build video ended up being so long, we decided to actually make this a two-video project. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and smash that notification bell. You're not going to want to miss the big test. We're going to see just how good this is at blowing leaves, knocking people over, launching random objects into the air, plus, and throw on the Iron Man suit. Thanks for watching.
James said do it with one hand. Hence, one hand.
James, I did it with one hand.
Laser bandsaw means laser stays in one place and you move the workpiece.